Sir, shall we start?
Yeah. We can start now.
Yes. Very warm good afternoon to all my dear participants. Today we are on the fifth day. That is the last day of this virtual workshop on artificial intelligence and business management. And today we have a resource person, a very eminent resource person with us. That is Professor Ramesh K. He is from Department of Computer Science, Karnataka State Akkamadevi Women's University, Vijaipur. We are happy to have him as a resource person. Thank you for accepting our invitation, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Now, I would like to request Anusha to kindly briefly introduce our resource person to the participants. Anusha, please.
Thank you, sir. A very good afternoon to one and all. Today, I'm very pleased to introduce our resource person, that is Dr. Ramesh K. As just now sir told, he is working as a professor in Department of Computer Science, Karnataka State Akkamahadevi Women's University, Vijaipur. Sir has completed his basic degree in BE in Computer Science and Engineering. He has completed his MTech from VTU Belgavi. He has got his PhD degree awarded by Karnataka University Dharwad and postdoctoral fellowship awarded from University of Malta, Malta. Sir have very rich experience in 15 years in teaching and 10 years in research. He also have very wide experience of administration and has worked in various capacities in different universities. He holds a professional expertise in programming languages, operating systems, technologies like MFC, TCP/IP, CORBA, XML, etc., and methodologies like RUPs, personal software processes, team software process, and design patterns. Till now, sir has successfully guided 3 MPhils and 1 PhD, and currently 5 scholars are pursuing PhD and 3 scholars are pursuing their MPhil under his guidance. His research interest lies in communication networks, graph algorithms, fiber optic communications, and system automation. Sir has also authored 5 books and successfully completed a research on design of an algorithm to improve signal-to-noise ratio sanctioned by UGC under the 12th plan. Sir has also presented and published more than 50 papers in various seminars, conferences, and reputed journals. He has chaired more than 5 international and international level conferences and has delivered many invited special lectures. He has also participated in international conferences and that are held in foreign countries. We are very honored to have you with us today, sir. I heartily welcome you to this session. And also, on the behalf of the management department, I welcome all the participants to this session. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you very much. Sir, see, my voice is clear, no? I have the good voice, no?
Yes, sir. You are audible.
So thank you very much, the organizing secretary, Matpati sir, then the chairman of the department, Professor Mallikarjun. So today, you are out of your 5-day, the workshop on artificial intelligence, perspective of management. So in this today, what I'm going to talk on is, see, I will not teach what algorithm is, what the function is, or how do we write algorithms, or how do we write a program, but just I'll talk about how does the artificial intelligence, the technological disruption has invaded the business, and how does the products or the what are the services, what are the platforms are available with the market, and all those things are. What are the softwares or the software platforms are available with industry, and how many of the companies are available who are selling the AI softwares and AI platforms, and how does the customers, the businessman, the organizations, then the industries, and in what way they have got the benefited from the artificial intelligence is all about I'm going to speak on. And my perspective is artificial intelligence for business. As you all know that nowadays, the predictive analytics of artificial intelligence and the digital disruption He is really transforming the business models, the business processes, and the business relationship among the industries. And even the organizations really, they have got increasingly confronting for the changes that to be adopted with the artificial intelligence technologies. So what I suggest is there are, after this, the some of the slides, I'm going to tell you what exactly the business people can go with or how can they go with the artificial intelligence, so they can make use of the artificial intelligence in the business management perspective. You can imagine here, see, you are seeing here some of the pictures here, where these are nothing but the imaginations. And what we feel is these imaginations you have also seen in either in the film trailers or some movies you have seen. But today, by the advent of the revolutionizing development of the artificial intelligence is giving some vision that these things are going to be possible in coming days, because of the developments of the artificial intelligence is going in a such a path that these are going to be possible in coming days. You can see some of the services here. See, this is the smartphone is there. Smartphone is helping you out in every event for every customer here. And you know that a smartphone is connected, when it is connected with the internet, it can have the abundant data, and that data is flown from the internet. And this, the second picture is, it is all about IoT. The IoT is Internet of Things. It is because of the advent and the modulation of the radio frequency. The every device, the pretty device nowadays, they are becoming the IoT devices, because they are able to communicate each other because of the availability of the radio frequency. Somewhere we heard that we are also having the AI driven cars, and we know that we are also experiencing, there is a face recognition systems are there. There are some lingual translations are there. So whatever the language you want, you can also, there will be a translation. And also there is a Google, it's a massive company. It is massively leveraging the data that is available with the internet. And it is, and its search engine is so efficient that nowadays everyone is, if something is required, they are going to Google with it, so that they can get the information available with that. Because of their efficient search engine only, it has become the possible. Why is AI becoming usable for business? See, there are three things are there here: the algorithms, then the data, then the computing power. The algorithms are intelligent the steps, are intelligent the formulae, are intelligent methods, where they are going, where they are going to have an access of this data. If I want to talk about data, the data has become abundant nowadays because of the development of the internet and driven by the software. So, and the smartphones and the internet and the cloud platform. And these three things, really, they are providing abundant data to the AI scientists, where they can access the data available with them, then they can write an algorithm, and the same algorithm can be embedded on this, the computing power. The computing power is a processor. So the processor is, in generally we say that microprocessor. So microprocessor is nothing but it's a processor. Whatever the function, if you want to embed, that is going to compute that function, then it gives a result for us. And once some few examples I want to give you, I want to give some analogy about the data. Data is nowadays oil for some of the companies. For example, Google is there, the Facebook is there, Netflix is there. And the data has become very valuable resource for them. And they are leveraging in a such a way that all the AI services and all the AI platforms, they are developing in such a way that every day there is one API is going to be developed by them, either from the Google or from the Facebook. So that one example I would like to give, how the artificial intelligence has given the efficiency in the business is, there is one company, UPS. UPS is a company which is a transport company in the USA, which has got 55,000 trucks. And they are able to deliver, or they are going to deliver around 16 million deliveries daily. How do they manage the routing? See, the routing is, It's an intelligent routing that is provided by the AI algorithm is algorithm. Because of that AI driven the routing algorithm, they are able to provide 16 million deliveries using only the 55,000 trucks. So that is one of the biggest advantage of the AI technology. The one more thing is you can observe that the Google is really, it is mastered in artificial intelligence algorithms. You can see that every day you are seeing the maps, Google Maps, and you can, there is a Google Earth is there, then Google search engine there. See, sometimes earlier what we were doing is if some address we require, we used to ask somebody. But if you just have a Google map with you, that device can take you to the address that you want. So that is what the sort of the computing, the complex computing that is done by the artificial intelligence driven technology. That's what I want to say. Why this AI becoming invading the business today is because of the data that is available with the cloud computing platform, supported by the intelligent algorithms and the computing power that made really artificial intelligence to invade the business today. That invasion, the one map that example I want to give is, that is a heat map. This is a heat map, you can say, the deals distribution by category. These are the categories of the companies here. The AI is heating up from the healthcare to finance, healthcare to education, healthcare to personal assistance, healthcare to finance and HR tech, all these things, all the areas, in almost all area, the AI has become really providing the wonderful services in them. One example I would like to give, the recent example is during the COVID-19, AI algorithms help them to track the patients or to give the recovery results and or give the everyday statistics. See, all these things are given by the artificial intelligence, the algorithms. And that's what the healthcare management, because of that artificial intelligence, the services, the official burden has reduced, even for health department, even for the government. Even government was switched over to artificially intelligent services and the platforms to deal with the COVID-19 disruptions. So these were the really, artificial intelligence technology helped even the government. Even government is also talking about whatever, even you can see that the Arogya Setu is an app. It is also working on the artificial intelligence, the technology. So we have used them. We are also member to them. So the healthcare has really reduced the burden because of the artificial intelligence technology. And even we can have an agriculture also. In agriculture, what is that? Even scouting, phenotypic, then ant biotech, and we have field forecasting, and also disease identification can also be done using the artificial intelligence algorithm. So therefore, these are really, the AI is heating up from the healthcare to all the areas. You can just see that there is a quarterly, in quarterly period, these are the almost all areas the AI has captured the market here. Even because of the artificial intelligence, the invasion, the funding or the investment also grown up. You can see by 2017, there is a $245 million investment is happened in the market. You can see in the 2012, there was only the 23 million was there. This shows that there is an increase in the investment because of the artificial intelligence, the technology developments. So it is really clear. So almost all the companies, they are switching over. See, you can see, I can say that most of the companies, either they have artificial intelligence service or they are running artificial intelligence platforms. Therefore, the investment is going high. But there is, today it is in 2021, there might be the investment might have gone double the money of 2017. And also you can see that AI is rapidly moving from inflated expectation to productivity. 100% the productivity has grown up. There is no inflation at all. You can see here the arrows here. See these things. almost all areas they have got the productivity. These are, again, I can say that these blockchain management, then the smart robots, then micro data centers, IoT platforms. So IoT platforms. See, IoT is Internet of Thing is also, it is a part of artificial intelligence. I don't know about whether you know it or not about the blockchain. Blockchain is a securing money. It is like Bitcoins. It is one of the Bitcoin, and blockchain is really doing well in European countries. Almost all the banks, they are having the blockchain, the software. Using the blockchain software, the whatever the money you credit in the bank, there will be, it is going to be a safest locker. It is safest locker kind of the software. It is related to the financial management. So blockchain, I don't know, but we are not hearing much about blockchain in India, but blockchain is there in Europe more, and even US also. And blockchaining requires the highly artificial intelligent, the algorithms, logical algorithms to operate them. So therefore blockchaining has become very good in Europe. We may also see in coming days the blockchain will also invade the market in India also. Then what all the technology, what all the services, what all the platforms, and what are the technologies the artificial intelligence provides? See, these are the services. These are the services built on AI. Amazon is there. Amazon, Netflix, we have heard about the Netflix. And also we have cognitive scale. We have heard about the cognitive scale. These are the services that are available with AI built-in services. And these are the platforms. These are the platforms that are platforms are SaaS and APIs. API is nothing but it is application protocol interface. It is when you run this one on your, either on your system or on your Android based with the mobile, this application is going to be executed. For example, one example I would like to give you is these APIs, these platforms will be maintained on the cloud. For example, if your mobile does not have Google Meet, then if you want to start a meeting, then just you are going to you are going to click on the install of the Google Meet. Immediately that Google Meet will be searched from the cloud, then immediately it will be stored on your mobile, and that API will start getting working on that, so that you can start the meeting. Like that, there are so many things are there. If you want to see the PDF document, if you don't have PDF, if immediately if you open some PDF that is you have received from the some other fellow, then if you click on that, if you don't have PDF on it, that immediately you will get a chatbot that install this PDF. And immediately if you click on that, it will go to the cloud server. Immediately that will fetch the executable file on your mobile or your computer. Immediately you can see the PDF. Like that, almost all platforms are available with the cloud services. And these are the technologies and research the companies that are there with the AI, based on the AI technology. These are some of the DeepMind is one of the most important the company that is working on AI platform development company, where it is under, it also carries some research algorithms, research on algorithms that are related to the that are relevant to the artificial intelligence technology. And these are the things that are available on the market. You can see here technology stack. What are the technology stack available? See, we have data science, machine learning, then we have natural language processing, then the development, then the data capture. And these are the things, enterprise intelligence. These are the enterprise visual, audio. What are the things enterprise intelligence means? The entrepreneurs will have the visual, audio, sensor, then internal data, then the market, all those things they can have. Even they can have enterprise functions. If some enterprise wants to have some functions like sales function, the marketing function, or security function, or recruitment function, they can have using the the artificial intelligence services, and also you can have autonomous system. If any organization wants to go for autonomy, then immediately you can ask for these things. The aerial or the industrial or the personal, there are some of the agents where they can automate your organization. And these are the industry specific artificial intelligence services available here. Agriculture, just I told you that in the last slide, the AI is heating up from the education to from the healthcare to entertainment, from healthcare to agriculture. So therefore, industries like agriculture industry, education, investment, then the legal, logistics, they can all can have artificial services. Even industries can have automate their material, or they can automate their retail finance also. And even the healthcare, I told you that healthcare is really functioning during the COVID-19 because of only it is the availability of the artificial intelligence technological services. And these are also available in the market. See, this one is artificial intelligence venture scanner. This venture scanner is a company where it automates a startups. If some startups are there, immediately it can take over that startup company. Immediately, what all the things it can provide is, it can automate, it can optimize, and it can personalize the startup, and it is nothing but a total guide for the startups. It is artificial intelligence is venture scanner. And you can see here, artificial intelligence retail market is also there. You know that retail market is really captured by artificial intelligence APIs. APIs are nothing but application protocol interfaces. So almost all, if you want to go for online shopping, immediately you can go for Myntra is there. Myntra is an online shopping is there. See, you cannot just get into Google, or you cannot go for shopping. You need to download an app, then you can register to it. Then you can ask whatever you want. Then you can go for the placing the order. Even those online shopping APIs are connected with the payment gateways. The payment gateway, either maybe it is a credit card, debit card, or it may be an online banking, or it may be some other kind of transactions. See, all payment gateways are also connected with APIs. See, there is one API, one application protocol interface. For example, there is one more example I want to give is Snapdeal is there. If you want to purchase something on a Snapdeal, you can place an order, as well as you can also go for a payment which is in a secured mode. See, all these things are because of it is an artificial intelligence services. See, I'm not going to define very much technically about what exactly the artificial intelligence is. Just I will brief you about artificial intelligence is only understanding and trying to give a reason. It is nothing but only it is the reasoning, and it is also testing with data. It is going to have a learn about the data and applies reasoning on it, then gives the result. The results are based on the tests. Tests are nothing but decisions. And some more, the casual definition is the capacity of a computer to perform operations analogous to learning and decision making. As I said that there is an abundant availability of data because of the internet, the cloud platform, and your Android phones. Therefore, the data is flowing in the abundance, and the data has become ubiquitous. Because of that ubiquitous, the decision making is also done on behalf of the humans because of the artificial intelligence, the services are the artificial intelligence driven algorithms. And there are the three kinds of artificial intelligence is there. There is a narrow intelligence. It is for specifically for one area. There is a general intelligence. It is for almost all area. There is a super intelligence is there. It is for only smarter than humans in every way is going to be applied on the artificial intelligence. These are the categories that are available in the artificial intelligence levels. You can see here. And then what are the skills of artificial intelligence today? The skills of artificial intelligence are, you can see here, the one is a natural language processing. I will not tell what exactly the natural language processing is. I will give some examples for the natural language processing. It is like your email filter. Email filter is natural language processing, and your search results are natural language processing. How can I make you to understand what exactly the natural language processing is? See, in a Google search engine, you will go, you are going to type something on it. Then immediately you will get the result. That is nothing but your request is processed. That your request is in the form of some language. That language is English here, and that English language is been processed, and that is processed, and you got the result on the Google search engine. So that is nothing but a natural language process. And also you can see that there is a audio language process. In audio language process, you have seen that anything you want to request on Google, then you can just say whatever you want. You are going to get onto on your screen by after the processing the search by the Google. So that is natural language processing. And also some language translation is there. If you want to translate from the Kannada to English, English to Kannada, or from some one document to another document, these are all things are nothing but language translation. So that is also, it is a part of a natural language processing. See, knowledge representation is nothing but capturing and acquiring of the knowledge. So whatever the capturing and acquiring is, the one example that I want to give the example is that is a decision making. The decision making is done by after learning the knowledge, acquiring the knowledge, then giving the decision is nothing but knowledge representation. The machine learning is an algorithm. It learns about data that what I give, what you give as an input. It will learn about it, then trains on its own. It's going to, it will get training from the data, then learns on its own and gives the decision. That is machine learning. Then automatic reasoning is it's an logical reasoning. If you want, the one best example is data mining. Whenever we are searching a group of information, there will be the big data is there, which is in the form of a terabytes. If you want to access only the few rows, then that can be done using the automatic reasoning technology. So it is going to implement some logical aspects on the database, then immediately it fetches whatever you want. For example, there is a terabyte of numbers are there. If you want to access the smallest number from that, then immediately the reasoning can be applied there, then you are going to get the result from there. Then there is one more thing is the skill of an artificial intelligence is there, automatic planning. So it is nothing but a scheduling. The scheduling is here. One example that I want to give is your in industry, if you want to plan a best workflow, then immediately you can have this the artificial intelligence skill, that is an automatic planning. This automatic plan can give an industry or an organization a best workflow scheduling. So it is nothing but it is going to give a scheduling process. It will strategic planning process it is. So it can use this for management people. This automatic planning is very important, the skill of artificial intelligence. If one learns about it, it is good for them. Then the artificial skills today that are available are, the AR understands the inputs, that is speech. As I told you, natural language processing. Then also it can recognize an image, that your the biometric. Your biometric is a best example where it has got the technology, that is the face recognition. And sometimes you used to thumb it. And at that time, the thumb was thumb is nowadays, it is not the recent technology, but even the face recognition become the more advanced than that. Then speech to text. See, somebody is speaking. You have a YouTube video where there is a speech is there. If it is, whether it is online or offline. If it is online, someone is talking and there is a live streaming is going on, and a whole speech can be converted to a text in the other part of the screen. At the one part of the screen, the fellow is talking. At the other part of the screen, the text you are going to see what he is talking. So that is also done through the AI skill it is. And AI manages knowledge. How AI manages knowledge is, it's an ontological it is. ontologies and the linked data. Whatever the data is linked, it is going to conceptualize on that data, then learns on the data, then makes the decision on that data. Then it is going to have a pre-trained data sets. Once any skill of an artificial intelligence based on the knowledge acquisition, if some data is given, then immediately it learns about the data, then it trains on its own. One example I would like to give is, there are some seizure patients are there. Seizure patients means fits. In generally what we say is seizure is nothing but a fits. If there are plenty, thousands together patients are there, their patients data is ECG, we call it as a EEG, that is E is a waveform. It is a wave, sinusoidal waveform it is. If somebody gets an EEG or somebody gets a seizure, he'll be taken to the hospital and he'll be scanned for EEG. That EEG is nothing but the waveform representation. Based on the waveform representation, the doctors say that whether the particular patient has the seizure or not. See that if those seizure waveforms are given to AI, a built algorithm, then it is going to learn about it, then later on, it can also predict that whether a patient he got today seizure may get in future the seizure or not can be predicted. That's what it is, nothing but the pre-training data sets are. Whatever the data you give, the algorithms will learn about them, sorry, get the training about them, then later on, they start learning on their own. Then these are the things that AI is going to execute on it. That is, we have an automatic reasoning is there. Just I told you that what is an automatic reasoning is. It's a logical reasoning, taking some decision on. Then we have automatic planning. I told you that it's a strategic scheduling plan it is. Then what AI learns? AI learns through machine learning, then AI learns to deep learning. See, nowadays, deep learning is very much the big, deep learning is the very advantageous skill of an AI, where Google is really implementing its almost all services with the deep learning only. For example, I told you that the email filters. So it filters whatever the unwanted. For example, you can see that your inbox, there are categories of the emails are there. In that categories of emails, it is done by the deep learning only. Email filtering, then blogs filtering, then tweets filtering, then the comments, that the contents of the emails, that the filtering can also be done through the deep learning. See, this is one example how the AI algorithm understands. See, this is an input here and how it recognizes the speech. You can see that I told you that speech is in the form of a wave. That wave is given to initially processed by the signal processing, then the signal is going to be processed and that is given to the deep learning algorithm, that is a neural network. It is a neural network is nothing but it is a deep learning algorithm. Then it is given to a decoder. The waveform is going to be converted to a textual, the cat is. So how this speech signal is going to be converted into the text. You may wonder where exactly does it happen. Just I told you that if somebody is speaking, there is a textual formation is done. The textual conversion is done. Whatever you speak, that text is going to be done. If some speaker speaks about the cat is, the cat that the input to the deep learning algorithm is a signal, pre-processed by signal processing, then it is given to the deep learning algorithm, then the decoder will recognize it, then immediately the text will be given to that. So like that, the speech of the video, the audio speech can be converted into the textual speech. So that's how we can do that one. So this is one example, how does the deep learning algorithm takes the input and gives the result. You can take this as an example for the audio conversion to the textual conversion. And you can see two more here. The big speech API is there. What it does, the big speech API is, it converts speech to text. If this API is installed on your either on your Android mobile or on your the computer, immediately the speech can be converted into the textual form. So this is an API, big speech API. One more is that cloud speech API. This one is a cloud speech API. See, I told you initially that how does AI has invaded the business, in what way the products have been got developed by the AI development, or the revolutionizing the improvisation of the AI. See, these are the products, some of the products where you can see today, the big speech API and cloud speech API. I don't see, my Android mobile does not have much of the APIs. I have seen somebody's the Android mobiles, there are n number of application protocol interfaces. The application protocol interfaces are nothing but they are the apps, we say generally app download maadi antna velthivi, that app is nothing but it is a API, that is application protocol interface. So if you download this big speech API, that can convert the speech into the text. And this cloud speech API, what it converts is it gives high quality streaming services, into real time audio and video. That is audio and video. For example, one example is somewhere if you want to listen to the speech, and see, I am talking about, and some of your participants are not here, they have joined this the whole meeting online, and they are able to listening. So what is that, how it is happening? It is happening based on the cloud speech API. What cloud speech API provides, it gives high quality streaming the services for real time audio and the video. If you install this one, you can have a good listening of the audio and the video application. And the other thing is understanding inputs, natural language processing. I told you that natural language processing or email filters and all things. How it does? See, it is basically, it is an emotional. There are what we call it as a, it is a semantic understanding. Semantic understanding means the natural language process will understand semantically. Semantically, for example, you can see here, there is a sentence is written, a dog is chasing a boy on the playground. Whole phrase, whole sentence will be understood by the natural language processing skill of an artificial intelligence. That is, A is a determinant, a dog is a noun, and is auxiliary, and chasing is a verb. See, all these semantics are going to be interpreted, and it is converted to a interpretation, inference. So it is written here, you can see here, it is used to read the sentiment in the language to analyze. Sorry, here it is text, it is written here. Natural language processing can be used to, the natural language process can be used to analyze any text to extract topics, sentiments, meanings, and ultimately to gain a knowledge. What is that? Again, you can see this, a dog is chasing a boy. The dog is running here and there is a boy is there. So the whole thing will be interpreted and it will give a sentence that a dog is chasing a boy on the playground. See, this is how natural language processing is exhibits its skill. It is one of the best skill in the artificial intelligence technology. And one more thing, you can have your understanding inputs or natural language processing is, these are some of the services provided by the market is tone analyzer, natural language understanding, natural language classifier. See, these are some of the products that are available with the natural language processing. If these are installed, you can have a natural language processing either on your the mobile device or on your laptop or on your desktop. See here, say that is about the natural language processing, and you can see that image also. If this image is given, how it recognizes, see, there are the series of filters are there. These filters are going to filter them, then the image will be inferred what exactly the image is. The image will first read the edges, then nose and eyes, then the faces, then whole your face is recognized. That happens even in your biometric also. That biometric has got the face recognition technology. So whenever usually the whole, the edges of your faces, then the components on your face, then whole face is recognized. Then it recognizes who is exactly in front of the the biometric keys. That's how the face recognition technology works. And this is about the clarity of the image. You can see here, understanding input. See, whatever the input you give here, it understands, then it gives the clarity over the picture. And what I told you, that managing knowledge, what knowledges are want, what ontologies and linked data, how they are going to be processed. You can see here, person will have a real name, then he may have his Twitter. See, for example, somebody will search in Google Scholar or in your the Google search engine. If you want to search some person, you are going to type his name. His name is nothing but it's a string. His name is a string, and that fellow is having Twitter account. Then it will search for the Twitter account, and if he is having some blog accounts, then it will search with the blog account and blog name also. With the blog name, it is going to search. See here, searching is done with the two servers, Twitter server, then the blog server. To whom you are searching, you are just going to search, you are going to type his name. His name is a string. Along with that string, immediately it is going to search in the search engine of a Twitter and the blog Twitter. If this person is there, immediately you will get the result. See, that's how the ontology is with the linked data. How does the person's linked data is there? Say, the person's linked data is Twitter and the blog. If someone is registered to some other servers, then also it is going to search there, then it will fetches the results for you. See here, how does it recognizes? If this person, particular person you are searching, if he has an account in the Twitter, he will have a content, and that content will be immediately retrieved. And he will have if some person that you are searching, if he has a blog here, and he will have a content in the blog, immediately the content of him is going to be fetched here. So like this, it is going to fetch us with the linked data. In how many number of servers you are recognized, you are registered, immediately you are going to get the information there. Like your Aadhaar card or your PAN card. See, PAN card and Aadhaar card numbers, if you are, all of your, the banks are interconnected with, our banks are tagged with the Aadhaar number. Why? Because if your the account holder name is typed, immediately the bank people will get the details of the Aadhaar entries, and also bank people will get the details of the PAN card entries. So like that, so the multiple server entries will be there. Based on that, it is going to search us. This is how, it's not on the one search, it is going to have a parallel number of searches, so that we can get the result immediately from the Google searching. That's what I told you, that Google search engine is an massively deep learning AI technological algorithm. So it, whatever you type, it searches almost all relevant to that. And one more thing is, you can see here how the search is based on the domain. It is domain may be the designation, and domain may be based on the topic, and the domain may be the based on the institution that he belongs to. Even I told you that some people they will have their entry in the universities. If you search with that name, then immediately that will fetch you that this fellow is a professor and he teaches this topic and he belongs to that university. So that is ontology. Ontology will fetch you the search from the multiple servers, and it gives the result. Therefore, the Google search engine is so popular nowadays because of its accuracy, because of the results of the accurate result it gives, almost all relevant to your search. And this is how what happened. Just I explained to you how the linked data will be there. So you will have a Twitter. See, you are going to write the search, the person search name here. Immediately it goes to some blogs, or it goes to some Twitter accounts or some other things, then immediately it links like this. So this person will get linked from this search engine, and this engine and this search engine immediately will get these results. These are the results you got from these servers, right? So that's how it is going to link. If some person, if you want to search from some university, just you type his name on a Google search, immediately it is linked with that particular university and fetches his all details to on your screen. So, and we have another, I told you the content. If somebody has content on a Twitter, based on the content also, you can search a person. See, I told you that the person can be, or anything can be searched, not only from the name or from the designation. The person can also be searched based on the content that he has in either in a Twitter the account or in a blogs account, whatever blogs he has an entries in that, you can get the details on that. And there is an IBM Watson Knowledge Studio is there. It is a platform that is given by the IBM company. It is developed by IBM company. What exactly this IBM company, Watson company is, IBM Watson is, it's an AI platform. It is an AI platform for the business. It is an AI platform for the business. Whatever the organization or the industries wants to have their automation, their optimization, and their interrelationship or their logistics to be very integrated, then they can contact this IBM Watson, IBM company. They will give this IBM Watson Knowledge Studio. I told you that it's an AI platform it is. If you install this one with the company, then you can do whatever the optimization you want, whatever the workflow planning you want, whatever the strategic planning you want, you can have with the industry or the organization. See, this is data sets and models. See, how does it man? It an AI skills manage the data means these are the data sets. Initially, they go with the edges, they go with the pixels. This is not much needed for you. So this is actually the data set from the minute data to the mega data. It is going to search for it. This is not exactly required for you. And you can see here, machine learning. I told you that machine learning is one of the skill. Machine learning is one of the skill of the artificial intelligence. So machine learning will have a label data. That is an input data. Just we have seen that image input we have given and audio input we have given, and the data is there. With the label data and the data, it will the machine learning will get the training, then it will predict. The training is learning from by itself. That is, this is one machine learning algorithm. Algorithm is, I told you that it is an maybe a formula, maybe a mathematical step, or where it does some function, whatever the human wants. So it gives the training input data will be given to the machine learning. It learns based on the data available. See, it learns based on the data available, then it predicts. Prediction is nothing but a result. See, one best example I want to give is, I told you that IBM Watson is there. See, if some industry is there, if it wants to install IBM Watson, or if you want the company wants to have an IBM Watson, if there are 1,000 employees are there, and there are 20 units are there, working units are there, then immediately you give the data as 1,000 employees and 20 units of an the company, working units of a company. Immediately it gives the workflow. Immediately it gives how does that 1,000 people can work with the 20 units. That workflow prediction can be done using the machine learning algorithm. That's what the industry fellow can make use of this one. And there are types of machine learning are there. Supervised learning is there. I will not tell what exactly the supervised learning is. Email spam detector is a supervised learning. There is an internet, there is an email spam detector is there. That email spam detector will be your supervised learning. And unsupervised learning is there. What is that unsupervised learning is? Your cluster similar documents means, if there are, you can see that in your what is that album is there. There is an album in your mobile. In that album, it classifies or it categorizes the similar photos. Whenever you take the clicks, whenever you take images, whenever you take snapshots, then immediately based on those snapshots, it can give some the clustering of the similar documents, clustering of the similar photos. That is nothing but unsupervised learning. Then reinforcement learning is learn to play chess by winning or losing. See, your mobile can play chess. That is nothing but a reinforcement learning it is. See, these all the machine learning will have supervised, unsupervised, then reinforcement learning. So this is not much required for you. I told you that supervised is an email spam, and clustering the photos of similar photos is your unsupervised learning, and the playing games is a reinforcement learning. The games, the gaming is deployed with reinforcement learning of the machine learning algorithms, right? Email spam will be having a supervised learning deployment. Then you have the clustering of similar documents, you will have a deployment of unsupervised learning algorithms. And you can see here what type of problems machine learning can learn. See, machine learning can learn the classification. Classification is categorization. And it is a regression is nothing but a statistics, right? It's a regression is nothing but a statistics it can deal with. And clustering is nothing but it is grouping. It is also unsupervised learning. Clustering is nothing but it is a grouping. And anomaly detection is it is a detection of a event or a person. So this kind of problems the machine learning can solve. What machine learning can solve? It can solve the problem of classification. It can solve the problem of regression. It can solve the problem of clustering, and it can solve the problem of recognizing or the detection of an event or a person or anything or a wave also. And these are the platforms. I'll tell you the machine learning platforms, how many are there. See, whatever here are there, Amazon Machine Learning is there. That is a platform. And machine learning platforms, very few well-known for you is machine learning platforms are MATLAB is there. Again, IBM Watson Studio is there. Google AI platform is there. Then Alteryx is there. Apart from that, one is Amazon Machine Learning. You can see here, I told you about the deep learning. See, deep learning is the mimicking of human brain. So mimicking human brain means the abundant data it takes, it learns about it, then it gives the result. We'll not much discuss on what exactly the deep learning is. Deep learning is also one of the skills that is available in the artificial intelligence. The technology, and just you see that how it does. See, image is given here, it filters here, it goes through all the filters, and here deep learning is learning about this data, and this, then it gives the prediction and it gives the result that this is a cat. So image is the image of a particular animal is learned about it, then it will be named. One good example I'll give. This is filtering spam. How the spams are filtered. See, you know that the spam is one of the classification of the inbox that you receive. And that spam classification will be filtered again based on the deep learning. So that is also done. And I told you that playing games is also, it is all about the deep learning. And this is streaming of the movies. Streaming of a movie is, how do you stream the movies? You will not stream every movie. What you select the name of a movie. Then that name of a movie, based on that name of a movie, then that film is going to be streamed. That is, again, it is nothing but based on the deep learning. And one more thing, you can see here, if this picture is given, and this, the deep learning will algorithm learn about it, then it gives what exactly it is, a group of people shopping an outdoor market. See, this image is given to artificial intelligence skill. Then it gives the result that how does that group, what exactly this image is. This image is all about, after learning, a group of people shopping at an outdoor market. Just see that how exactly it is giving. That is happening here, shopping market out there. And you can see here, a close-up of a child holding a stuffed animal. If this is image given, it will give this one, that a child is holding a stuffed animal. And if this is given, it gives what it is. It is a pizza. See, this is labeling. Labeling is also done by the deep learning skill of artificial intelligence. And this is, you can see that what exactly it is, a man flying through the air while riding a skateboard. So like this, whatever the labeling you want, you do, and whatever you want to identify an image, you can, that is done through the deep learning. So that's how you can, this also, if 2D image is given, it can also convert 3D image. See, this is really the amazing technology, 2D to 3D imaging. And this also, the labeling is not an easy job. See, that learns about the image, then it gives what exactly is there in the image. So that's what the wonder of the, that's really fantastic, the brilliant, the skill of an deep learning artificial intelligence is. And this is car, we are heard about the car nowadays. There are some cars, they are driven by AI technology. We have not seen, so far today, but we are going to see tomorrow. And this AI driven cars, we may see, we may drive and we may sit in the car in future. And there are some conversate means we have chatbots. We say them chatbots. These are the chatbots. So you say somewhere you are something you are registering, or somewhere you are booking something. In while booking something, that response you are going to get, we call it as a chatbot. There is no human that responding. You do this, you do that, you enter your this, your address. All these things are given by the chatbots. We say them as a chatbots. You chatbots are there embedded in your Android phone also. So yeah, chatbots will help you registering something or searching something. How does we exactly build the AI? See, there will be a scientist will be there. They are based on the data scientist. They use the data, then they use the platform, then they use the product, then they will develop the product. There are platforms of the artificial intelligence. They are used by the data, then the data scientist will use the data and the platform and the algorithms, then they develop the artificial intelligence product. See, what I suggest to your the managing people is, if you want to really have the fun with artificial intelligence, the softwares and the platforms, you need to have these three things. One is the landscape of technological disruption. You need to have an idea about this. The business of data and machine learning. See, machine learning, you need not to be a technologist. You need not to be a mathematician, or you need not to be an engineer. Just you can have platform. You can just buy the platform, use it, and you can have in your business data to be manipulated. The one more thing is AI in practice. You should have all the services that are provided by the AI. If you have the practice of them, definitely the management is going to be technologically driven. And you can have, I told you that another one is the strategic leadership in the age of AI. And this is also, these are the four things if you want to make AI, the platforms and the AI services to be used very efficiently in our management skills. All these things, you see, this is what to say today. I thank Matapati for inviting me. Almost it is 1 hour. So I thank also the the chairman of the department, Professor Mallikarjun. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you. Thank you so very much, sir. Yeah. It was very informative, very enlightening, and you have made a concept very easy to understand, though yeah. It is much complicated, but with respect to business, you made it very simple and very easy to understand. Thank you so very much for your time, sir. Yes, participants, any questions from the participants? And if any questions, you can unmute yourself and you can raise the questions. Okay, no such questions, sir. Once again, I thank you on behalf of the Department of Management and on behalf of our university, as well as on behalf of all the participants. I thank you very much for the information you have shared, as well as the time you have given to us. Thank you once again, sir. And dear participants, we will be having a last session of this virtual workshop from 3:30, followed by the valedictory function. And the resource person for the last session would be Professor T. Mallikarjunappa, sir. He's a professor in Department of Commerce and International Business from Central University of Kerala. Kasaragod. So kindly join us.